Bandwagon NFL fans never stick with one team forever. It's all about cheering for a winner, and once their reign of dominance ends, it's time to cheer for the next great team. Just ask these NFL clubs who, for a very short period of time, enjoyed the support of countless bandwagon fans across the country. Eli Manning's New York Giants. Playing in the country's biggest market and all, the Giants never had problems recruiting local fans. From a national standpoint, the bandwagon really seemed to take off during the glory years of the Eli Manning, Tom Coughlin era. That was thanks in large part to Manning and the Giants defeating the evil New England Patriots empire not once, but twice in the Super Bowl. The Brady-Belichick Patriots became the NFL's biggest villains once the Spygate scandal became public knowledge, not to mention that they kept on winning, which naturally made them more despised across the NFL. So, when Manning and company defeated the Patriots in Super Bowl 42, thus ending their bid at a perfect 19-0 season, the Giants earned a lot more love and respect on a national level. Eli was a lovable younger brother of Peyton, no longer living in the elder's shadow. 4 years later, the Giants defeated the Patriots again on the big stage in Super Bowl 46. Manning repeated history by piecing together a clutch last-minute drive, and the defense once again prevented Brady from orchestrating a game-winning drive. With two Super Bowl victories over the evil empire, the Giants certainly earned some extra love outside of the Big Apple. But the Giants would endure a lengthy period of mediocrity after their glorious Super Bowl run, only making the playoffs once in Eli's final 8 seasons. The lack of success predictably led to the bandwagon jumpers shifting their fandom elsewhere as the team entered a phase of irrelevance. But hey, the Eli Manning Giants bandwagon was fun while it lasted. Without him, the evil Patriots would have not 6, but 8 Super Bowls. Greatest show on turf, St. Louis Rams. For a very brief period of time, the star-studded Rams were must-see material. They were led by MVP quarterback Kurt Warner and the Hall of Famers Marshall Faulk and Isaac Bruce, and 7-time Pro Bowler Torrey Holt, hence the greatest show on turf nickname. The Rams were heavily featured in primetime during their short and sweet reign of dominance. Warner was a lovable feel-good story when he led the Rams to a Super Bowl 34 victory over the Tennessee Titans. The Rams got back to Super Bowl 36 2 years later, only to fall to the New England Patriots. It was supposed to be the exclamation point on a dynasty, but instead, it led to the beginning of the end for the Rams' special run as well as their bandwagon. Injuries and lackluster play ended Warner's tenure with the Rams abruptly. The greatest show on turf was no more by 2003, and the team never really regained relevance in St. Louis. The franchise saw a notable decline in attendance during their final years in St. Louis, and they were eventually relocated to Los Angeles in 2015. They endured 5 straight losing seasons under head coach Jeff Fisher from 2012 to 16. Despite a quick turnaround under Sean McVay, the Rams struggled to build up much of a fan base in La La Land. Simply put, their bandwagon peaked during the greatest show on turf era. Tony Romo's Dallas Cowboys. The Cowboys were largely mediocre in the first half of the 2000s decade, but things began to turn a corner in 2006. Superstar wide receiver Terrell Owens was added in free agency, and the Cowboys benched Drew Bledsoe in favor of Tony Romo. Finally, America's team was back. Romo emerged as one of the NFL's top quarterbacks and led Dallas to the postseason in 2006 and 7. Suddenly, the Cowboys were must-watch TV thanks to an explosive offense. They sent 13 players to the Pro Bowl in 2007, an NFL record. Bandwagon fans loved Romo, and suddenly this team looked poised to win multiple Super Bowls. But it just wound up being the same old song and dance. Romo consistently underachieved in big games. Dallas endured unforgettable late-season collapses in 2008 and 11 to miss the playoffs. Injuries also derailed several promising seasons from Romo, and as the Cowboys endured a frustrating run of mediocrity, a lot of bandwagon fans just gave up and found a new team to support. It was easy to get tired of the Cowboys' constant media attention and primetime TV spots. Jerry Jones employed Jason Garrett for 10 years, which did nothing to fix the Cowboys' constant shortcomings. The Cowboys' bandwagon in the Romo era was hot from 2006 to about 2011, before evaporating over time. Jim Harbaugh's San Francisco 49ers. The 49ers were among the NFL's worst franchises, but things quickly turned around when they hired Stanford head coach Jim Harbaugh to lead the way in 2011. The passionate head coach quickly turned the 49ers into a juggernaut. They'd reached 3 straight NFC Championship games in his first 3 years there. His decision to start dual-threat quarterback Colin Kaepernick over Alex Smith in the midst of the 2012 season paid off big time. Kaepernick took the league by storm with his rushing abilities, leading San Francisco to a Super Bowl 47 appearance. They narrowly fell to the Baltimore Ravens, but the bandwagon was growing at a rapid pace. Harbaugh's Who Got It Better Than Us movement swept across the NFL. The 49ers were prominently featured in primetime games, and their fans often packed visiting team stadiums. But injuries to key players and behind-the-scenes drama between Harbaugh and GM Trent Baalke led to a disappointing 8-8 season in 2014. Harbaugh left the 49ers and went to coach the Michigan Wolverines. key players like Patrick Willis, Justin Smith, and Chris Borland retired, and several other impactful guys were lost in free agency. Without Harbaugh, the 49ers slipped to the bottom of the NFL standings. The team didn't get back on track until Kyle Shanahan and Jimmy Garoppolo arrived in 2017, helping the 49ers return to relevance. The Harbaugh era was fun for a short period, but once the losing returned, the 49ers lost who knows how many bandwagon fans. 2006 to 2010 San Diego Chargers. Perhaps no team had more superstar talent than the Chargers from 2006 to 2010. Does anybody else remember playing these guys in Madden? Rivers, LT, Vincent Jackson, and Antonio Gates were quite the unstoppable force. It was easy for fans to hop on the Chargers bandwagon for obvious reasons. Tomlinson won the MVP award in 2006 after helping the Chargers finish with the NFL's best record at 14-2. They reached the AFC Championship game the following season. Despite losing to the Patriots, the future never felt more promising for this team. San Diego was a juggernaut in the making. Tomlinson was one of the NFL's most popular players. Rivers was arguably the league's third-best quarterback behind only Brady and Peyton Manning. Gates and Jackson were superstars, and that defense led by Sean Merriman, Antonio Cromartie, and Eric Weddle was no joke either. But despite all that world-class talent, the Chargers couldn't advance past the divisional round in 2008 and 9. Tomlinson was released in the 2010 offseason and signed with the New York Jets, thus ending a glorious era in San Diego. They inexplicably underachieved and missed the postseason in 2010 and 11, which made the franchise more and more irrelevant again. The Chargers were barely featured in primetime games, they struggled with attendance, and Qualcomm Stadium was largely filled by visiting teams' fans. Their support outside of California quickly drifted away, and the franchise relocated to Los Angeles in 2017. This fan base's bandwagon peaked during the LT Rivers years, and we wish the Chargers good luck in getting back to that level. 2010-11 Philadelphia Eagles. The short-lived Eagles bandwagon started because of one man, Michael Vick. Vick signed with the Eagles in 2009 and saw very little playing time because of Donovan McNabb, but the latter was traded to Washington in the 2010 offseason, and when starter Kevin Cobb suffered a concussion in Week 1, Andy Reid made Vick the starter. The GOAT of dual-threat quarterbacks took the Eagles' offense to a whole new level. He endured an epic Comeback Player of the Year campaign, winning 8 of 12 starts to help the Eagles claim the NFC East title. Philadelphia's bandwagon grew following a thrilling 2011 offseason spending spree. They signed Vince Young to back up Vic, as well as standout defensive players Colin Jenkins, Jason Babin, and of course, all-pro cornerback Nnamdi Asamoah. Young even called the 2011 Eagles the dream team, and the bandwagon only continued to grow. Philly was showcased in 5 primetime games, but they weren't exactly watchable if you catch our drift. Injuries to Vic and lackluster production from Philly's top guys led to a frustrating season. The Eagles had to win their final 4 games just to salvage an 8-8 record. Many expected the Eagles to rebound and break through in 2012, but they finished a disappointing 4-12. Reed was fired, and the bandwagon created by Vic's resurgence was officially done for. Peyton Manning's Denver Broncos. After his release from the Indianapolis Colts, Peyton Manning became the NFL's most sought-after free agent in the 2012 offseason. He talked with seemingly half the teams before signing with the Denver Broncos. Being one of the league's most marketed and accomplished athletes, Manning quickly sparked a giant Broncos bandwagon movement. I mean, it wasn't much different from what we saw when Tom Brady went to Tampa last offseason. But it was also the Broncos' consistent winning that led to the rapid growth of their popularity. Manning led Denver to 4 straight AFC West Division titles and 2 Super Bowl appearances. The Broncos won it all in the 2015 season, Manning's swan song year. A 2014 Harris poll with 2,543 participants showed that the Broncos were the most popular team in America, even over the Dallas Cowboys. Jerry Jones' team had placed number 1 in each of the previous 6 years. When you throw in a large quantity of primetime games and when you remember how many Broncos fans traveled to visiting stadiums, you could just tell how huge the bandwagon had grown. But after Manning's retirement, the Broncos slowly became one of the NFL's worst teams. They kept changing coaches and quarterbacks, but nothing worked. The consistent primetime TV appearances were no longer a thing, and you sure didn't see a lot of bandwagon fans wearing Broncos attire anymore. The 4-year run with Manning was good times, and once the team began to slip to the bottom of the standings, it was over. Legion of Boom Seahawks. Remember this one? The Seahawks have always had a loyal fan base in Washington State. I mean, the 12th man thing was around long before Russell Wilson and the Legion of Boom arrived. But nationally, the bandwagon grew to spectacular heights when the Seahawks became one of the NFL's elite teams in 2012. They struck gold in the draft, landing Wilson, Bobby Wagner, Jeremy Lane, and Bruce Irvin. The Seahawks were a likable underdog in 2012, winning 11 games before narrowly falling to the top-seeded Atlanta Falcons in the divisional round. But that's okay. The bandwagon was just getting started. All of a sudden, Seahawks fans could be seen everywhere, even in bunches, while on the road. Seattle's neighbors in the Canadian province of British Columbia also heavily jumped on the bandwagon. A 2015 poll showed that the Seahawks were the third most popular sports team in British Columbia, even ahead of the hometown Vancouver Whitecaps from Major League Soccer. The bandwagon was at its boiling point when the Seahawks defeated the Broncos in Super Bowl 48, and again when they advanced to Super Bowl 49, narrowly falling to the Patriots. But in 2015 and 16, the Seahawks endured consecutive exits in the divisional round. They missed the playoffs in 2017, and the Legion of Boom era ended with Cam Chancellor retiring and Richard Sherman getting released. Seattle was no longer one of the NFL's elite teams, and the bandwagon Seahawks fan could no longer root for their favorite stars. The Seahawks are still a competitive and relevant team, but this isn't the league's most popular bandwagon anymore. Oh well, at least the Seahawks know who their true fans are now. While other NFL bandwagons ended quickly, join us in the comments section below. If you like this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton and we appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around to TPS though, subscribing is a great idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching and we'll see you guys next time.